Final Fantasy VII Remake. Whew, damn! I have put a lot of hours into this game, and to be honest, the hours are totally worth it. I've been taking my sweet time with this review, but today is a rainy day, so no disc golfing for me. That requires a review. Now, to make things clear, I have not played the Final Fantasy VII Original Edition, but I already put an order in for the PS1 version of that game. I'm not promising to play it, but at least I have the copy. That is why I can't truly compare them, but at least I can give out my opinion of or on that remake. So let's get into it! Final Fantasy VII Remake is an action RPG set in dystopian cyberpunk metropolis of Midgar. Players control mercenary Cloud Strife as he and an eco-terrorist group known as the Avalanche oppose a powerful megacorporation Shinra from using the planet's life essence as an energy source. So I began this game thinking that it might be similar to Final Fantasy XV, which I liked very much. But it turns out that they are completely different. I also learned that none of these games are connected story-wise. In fact, in the beginning, I was stupid enough to think that Cloud was Noctis. Please don't judge me on that stupidity. So the story. I love that this game had this spark of action-adventure with strong character building. Since the beginning of the game, you slowly learn about each character, why they are together and what was their past. It's done well enough for me to actually care. I didn't skip any dialogue, cutscenes or content in general. So story, yeah, I mean this game has story and a lot of it, around 40 hours worth. As you play, you feel that you have discovered so much, you have been through hell and heaven. After a week in this game, well, about 3 to 4 hours a day, it still keeps being interesting. I'm not spoiling much here, but you discover multiple cities, hidden roads, secret quests, quite a few minigames, and a heck of a bunch of collectibles. Music and manuscripts. I think they were called manuscripts, I'm not sure. So sometimes you only get a hidden mission if you have made right choices previously. If the word coin means anything to you. But your progression in this game is linear, meaning that if you advance too far, you can't go back. Basically, that happens after each chapter. There are 18 of them, so, you know. Of course, if you finish the game, you unlock a chapter select, but I will come to that later on. All the cities are open, but most of the game is linear in nature. Narrow corridors with only one exit. But if you do manage to get lost, then most of the time you find boxes with materia and other treasures and goodies. But, you know, if you look behind places that you would normally go to and they turn out to be a dead end. Boxes might also contain gil, or chill. Let's say gil, sounds much better. Which is money in this game. You can buy armor pieces and jewelry to boost your stats, but can also be mounted with materia to give you skills. Materia basically is a rune that contains a specific attack or healing property. It can be magic like charming, blocking and healing, but also fire and ice attacks using the weapon they are attached to. And you don't only control one character, you control several at once, but only in battle. So the game is built like you traveling with a group of friends that changes over the course of chapters as the story progresses. But one common denominator is you. The character of Cloud. But you can control only him until the battle sequence commences. Battles in this remake are done in real time, luckily, but if you use your abilities, you can slow down the time as you make the choice of the attack you wish to use. Later on, you can also summon mighty beasts to fight alongside you, for a limited time, of course. As the battle commences, you can swiftly choose between the characters to spend their special attacks as well. And if the battle is over, you automatically gain control of Cloud again. I'm not getting into the specifics of MP points and potions and the battle system overall. You just need to know that you level up your character, equip shit for more defense and attack, and level up your weapons in this fabulously designed universe-looking menu. Battles are fast, intuitive and fluid. You know, some thinking is required as you discover weaknesses of each enemy, so smashing square doesn't work all the time. Graphically, this game is beautiful, as you can see. Fight cutscenes and character introductions are done in very anime style, very hentai-ish. A lot of titsen, big ones, wobbling. Okay, they're not wobbling, but you know, whoever designed them went all out.
This is a big one, eh? But look at the titsen. This will bounce nice for you.
Was there a guy who was specifically hired to design tits?
Tits. Tits.
tits.
Tits. Tits. Tits.
Tits.
Tits.
It sounds like tits. Ooh, and by the way, what I discovered was many similarities with Metal Gear in this game. I'm not sure if anyone noticed, but many corridors, character reactions, and even famous staircase run were all in Metal Gear as well. So, was that a hint? Is there some sort of a clue in Final Fantasy Remake? I'm not sure. But let's now get into stuff that wasn't all peaches and cream. The chapter select. Oh yes, after the end game, you can revisit all the chapters to clean up for Platinum Trophy. Well, I will tell you straight away, this one is not happening for me. You need to complete the game at least 3 times to get necessary dresses. You know what I mean. You know what I mean if you're aiming for Platinum. You also need to level up all your weapons. Your progression will carry over to new game, but if you missed anything in one chapter, you need to recomplete it from the beginning to end. About 120 hours to Platinum, and that is the time I can't spend on this game. Oh, I forgot to mention that this game also comes on 2 Blu-ray discs. 2 discs in total, so more than 100 gigs of space is needed. Last 2-disc Blu-ray game was Red Dead Redemption 2. Anyways, I'm not going to babble around. Final Fantasy VII Remake is a great game that offers a lot of fun for weeks and weeks, weeks and weeks and weeks. And I give this game an 8 out of 10, the same score as 15. Yeah, well, you know. Please do not go and see that other review I did for 15. I just opened it 10 minutes ago and it was appalling, it was disgusting, it was cringeworthy because, you know, my English and my emotion, well, you know, there wasn't any. So my first videos, cringe squared. Anyways, I hope that you liked this video. If you did, hit that like, smash that bell, and if you dare, subscribe as well. I'm Silly Llamas, and thanks for watching. Till next time.